powered by NVIDIA Quadro.
Classic Car or Muscle Car, we want to show you how to restore your automobile and save yourself some money in the process. Sometimes we consult the pros, sometimes we mess up. But just remember, it's never a problem, it's always a project.
Up next on Auto Resto Mod, we finalize the drum brake install on the 66 Mustang and we say goodbye to Cam.
Order a bunch of parts to get ready for the car show this weekend?
And I got a hot deal.
You think? Think again.
Oh, man.
Tired of back orders? You need NPD. With four strategically located superstores, orders are shipped direct to your door within 1 to 3 business days. National Parts Depot has quality restoration parts for Ford Truck, Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, and Firebird. For your free catalog, visit NPD online or call toll free.
Previously on Auto Resto Mod.
The parts we've got that we're going to be doing from National Parts Depot. If you want, you can go ahead and finish getting this side undone.
One thing you want to check for is see if there's any scarring, any kind of cracking on the casing. Sometimes the individual bearings themselves will look a little rough spots on. Yeah, this really shouldn't be getting brake fluid all over my hands like this. So we're replacing this, all of it. Oh, we're just going to take a quick second here to talk about safety. These cars have a great big cross member on the front, which makes it really convenient for lifting the whole front of the car in one shot. Do not do the work on the brakes while the car is on the jack.
Okay, we've got everything ready to go. Now, we've already gone and installed our brand new wheel cylinder and our brake hoses and the brand new lines we got from National Parts Depot. All the front lines on this car were so jammed up that we could not get them to come loose. The nuts here were just tight on the line itself. No matter what we did, using heat, using PB Blast, all those things didn't make any difference. We ended up crimping the lines, so we had to replace them. National Parts Depot stocks both the standard steel lines and the stainless like we've got here. Does this car really need stainless lines? But we put them on there anyway. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the little tips and tricks of things that you need when you're installing the drum brakes. Now you'll notice that on our pad points, which there are 6, all the way around the drum brake backing plate, we've gone in and welded and ground down all the plates where we had problems before where the shoe had eaten into the plate itself. These are now fairly smooth. They don't have to be perfect. They just need to be smooth enough that the drum can go in and out in its range of motion. We're also going to take a Q-tip and put a light amount of high temperature grease on these pads. The grease will just help that pad move back and forth across there. And you want high temperature because you're going to be generating a pretty good bit of heat in these brake drum sets. So now we've done all 6 of those. We're going to take our adjuster wheel, which is this piece here. You have a rotating section here, and this is on a screw set. Now you make your adjustments like we showed you through the port here to adjust the brake drums, but you want to put just a little bit of high temp grease on this piece here and on the thread so that it does have the ability to put some motion through here. And put this back on, and I'll set this aside for now. And on this side, I'll go in and put a little bit of grease on as well. Don't need to show you that because basically it's just greasing the threads. All right, I got my rubber gloves on. I'm going to go in and actually finish this up. Now, I recommend safety glasses for the rest of this because honestly, I really don't think grease is going to come flying off of that backing plate, but when you start working with the springs on this, it will cause some issues. All right, you put these in and they probably will not go all the way in. You can also put a little grease on the end of these if you want, but you want to try to get them to where they'll go inside the boot and that way they'll kind of stay put. And then the next thing you want to do is install your front shoe. Now the shoe sits with these plates like this. You'll notice it popped that other one out. Now you have your little rod assemblies. These rod assemblies go in through the backing plate and through the shoe. You have a back plate. Now these are available from National Parts Depot. We just accidentally forgot to order them, so we're going to use our old ones. If they're in good shape, you can reuse them. Now you take your front plate, you put it on there, and you have to kind of work it around to install it. Sometimes it's a little hard to find. And then magically it goes on. Now, before I go in and install it, make sure that your longer shoe goes on the back, not on the front. That's one of the most common mistakes I see when people are doing the drum brake setups, is they will put the longer shoe on the front. It does not go on the front. In fact, it goes on the back. It will mount up here, but that's incorrect. Another thing I'll talk about real briefly here is you'll see these slots here. These slots are actually for when you're doing the shoes on a back brake set. What these are for is there's a bar that goes across here that is part of the rear brake assembly, and that's what that is for. You will not be using this on the fronts. One more little thing I wanted to talk about before I mount this back shoe on is I am wearing gloves, and the reason I'm doing this is I don't want to contaminate the braking surface on my shoes with the oils from my hand, because that can create hot spots in the drum and cause poor drum braking quality. So before you go any further, if you're doing one of these, make sure you put you some rubber gloves on. Don't necessarily want to have them on when you're greasing, because that's going to create the same problem. After the greasing is done, before you put your shoes on, put on some rubber gloves. That'll keep you from messing up the shoes. Okay, the way I do this may be different than the way other people do it. I know that Cam did the other side in some odd, bizarre way that we don't even know, but what I do is I'll put the front spring on and set it aside for a second, and then I will install the wire which goes in the very back. Now, when you put this wire on, make sure that this is pointing up. There is a tab system with the way they put this together, and that should be pointing up so that this is pointing this way toward the hook. Now, you've got a plate that'll go over here, but you want to put your green spring on first so that you get a better set out of all this. Now, you'll take your brake tool and you'll lay it over, push it up against this, up against there, and it's set. Now, see, this has still got some mobility to it, but as long as it's up over here, you're not, if you let this slide down, it can get captured on top of the wheel cylinder and possibly bend this tab, and you gotta start all over. Now, you have a yellow spring that goes on next. Now, the yellow spring actually goes inside of this piece here. There's a hole over here on this side. The wire goes on top of that, and the spring installs in here. Now, the wire can come out. It's not really a problem for that on this. And you need to make sure that that sits up above the adjuster set there, like so. Put the spring tool in, pull everything into position. Bada bing, it's set. Make sure everything's sitting correctly and in good position, not binding on anything. Then you'll need to go in and set your adjuster on the bottom. I want to show you something before we go any further with this to kind of make my point about the backing plate pads that the actual shoes ride on. You'll notice how nice that action is. If you didn't have those backing plates greased and you had notches on the backing plates like our old backing plates had, this action would not be quite right. You'd have some problems with it. These things will take a set and a ride in a certain position, and it'll make the brakes harder to deploy. With the backing plates in good working order, this action is now correct and it moves through the range of motion the way it's supposed to. Just want to make that point before I go on to installing the adjuster. Now, when you put your adjuster in, make sure that you put it in with the correct end on the shoes. You want to make the adjuster where there's the hole back here. You can actually see a lineup between the teeth on the adjuster arm and the hole in the background, so that you can get your brake spoon in there to tighten the whole assembly up after you get everything done. All right, the next thing you want to do is you'll take your wire, install it on the cleat, put it through the hole, and make sure that everything is sitting where it should be sitting. Sometimes these wires will come off. And now, what you have to do is take this spring and run it over to that point there. I'm going to take my clamping pliers and put them on the spring back here. Pull that in, and voila. You now have a setup drum brake system. Now we're going to have to adjust this wheel out, and what we'll do is, after I clean the drum, I'm going to show you that next, we'll go in and start adjusting the drums out for correct position. But that's basically how you put a drum brake kit together on a car. Always recommend, if you can afford to do it, getting new components. If all this stuff is in fairly good shape, that's okay. Now, what I would recommend on all this stuff is always check your drums to make sure that you've got good turnout on them. If you can turn the drums, do so, because it'll save you a little bit of money. But if you can't, the drums really aren't that bad price-wise. You can go get a new set of drums and a new set of shoes and rebuild your brakes. The biggest thing to keep in mind of is, especially on these older cars, is to check your backing plates. The backing plates are the most important part of this, because you want good action of those drum brakes. Without those shoes being able to ride correctly on the back pads, you're going to have some problems with the braking on the car. I'm going to go and clean this drum off, show you how to do that, and then we're going to go ahead and finish up the installation. All right, we're almost to the finish point here. Now, I've got some brake parts cleaner, and I'm going to take and clean all the Cosmoline and the super greasy job that Cameron did to the drum for me. He went in and repacked the bearings, and boy, there was some packing done there, because there's a lot of grease on stuff. I just want to basically go in and spray it to get all that out. Now, I'm going to leave that in the bottom, and what I'm going to do is, I'm going to show you what that looks like. Now, that's normally pretty dang clear, and you can see how muddy that has already gotten just from that little bit of spraying I did for a second. So that gives you an idea of how much junk there is on the braking surface on these drums whenever they ship them. And they do that so they don't rust out. So now I'm going to go ahead and finish cleaning this up, and I'm going to mount it. I'm not going to go into too much more than that, but you'll get an idea of what we're talking about with some of the adjustments. All right, I've gone in and cleaned these a couple of times, and what you'll want to do is, paper towels may not be the best choice for this in some respects, but paper towels, you can go in and use an air gun to clean out all the residue if you get any residue on it. But you can look at this paper towel and see that pretty much it's coming really clean on the braking surface. We're not getting a lot of residue. Some of this is coming out from like on these upper edges, which I haven't really cleaned yet. You can see that's coming off of the top up here. That's not part of the braking surface. It's not that as much of an issue. So make sure that those are really nice and clean before you go back for your final installation. And as I don't know that I pointed this out earlier, but obvious, it's pretty obvious. I put a paper towel in here to keep the brake parts cleaner from getting down inside the hub assembly. So now that we've got that all done, I'm going to go get an air gun, clean the center of this out, make sure there's no residue in there, and get this put back together. Okay, I'm going to put my drum on and put on my final stuff. I've got everything cleaned up and ready to go. So the drum just slides over the shoes into position. And then your bearing goes in. And then put your washer and your nut. Now, the same procedure we've shown on the disc brake stuff applies here. And I'll show you that in just a second. Okay, we're hand tight. Got good rotation. Got a little bit of a tick and I can hear it. We may need to go in and do some sanding on one of the pads. And also that could clean up when we get this tightened in correctly too. All right, now on the drums that we have on here, we replaced the drums obviously. We used our original hubs. We had the stud assembly and the center hub pressed off and repressed onto the new brake drum itself, and you're going to have to do that if you're replacing your drums. Don't recommend trying to do this at home. You can do it at home. There's a couple of things I could show you how to do, but I'd rather see you guys go out and get this pressed in a machine shop, because you're pretty much assured that you're going to get the studs all the way back out. You don't have to worry about possibly boogering up the threads if a machine shop does it for you. What I'm going to show you now is, this is hand tight, and I'm going to tighten the nut up and spin the drum until it stops spinning easily, and then I'm going to back it off. Until I achieve decent spin out of it. You don't want to go too far back. If you go too far back, you're going to end up with a bad loose front end feel to it. The drums will actually walk around. So basically that's it. Put our castle nut back on, put our cotter pin back through there, and this side for that part of it is ready to go. Get everything tightened up and ready to rock and roll for driving on the street.
So if we hit the brakes, it should stop, right?
Well, it's not yet. We should put it on the ground first. And that's how you're going to adjust these, folks. What you're going to do is when you're adjusting out your brakes, you're going to need to go in and actually back the car up. And in backing the car up, you'll hit the self-adjusters and it'll adjust the brakes. You need to do that more than once. It's not just a one-time thing. So that's how you set up the brakes and adjust them. Sadly, though, we have something to talk about. Cam, our industrious little fellow with red hair, will be leaving us as of this week. This is his last week with us here at the show. It's a regrettable thing in one line because we will miss Cam. He's been an incredible help around here, but on the other hand, he is going off to school. He's going to be going off to learn a trade of diesel mechanics, so that's a good thing. So while he's going away, we'll be losing him, but we're going to be gaining a couple of other people. So next week, we're going to be coming back with how to do a convertible top in a Mustang or Ford product. Now, I think most of the convertible top stuff we're going to be talking about next week is going to be applying to pretty much anything, but we are going to be doing it on a 66 Mustang down at the guys at National Parts Depot's facility with Larry Gallion, their lead restore guy in their shop. Larry used to run an upholstery shop, so we're going to be putting the top on and doing that this coming week.
If it's like the new one, I just paid the guy.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll see when we get down there. Hopefully he'll give us some good tips. But guys have wanted to see that. You remember we had some people write in and asking about it. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to show them how to put a convertible top in a car. And it's been nice having you back with us this week. I know you've had a lot going on. You guys have been incredibly busy. You got the new job. People have been asking after you. Most of them had good things to say.
Most of them. Awesome. You can't please everybody.
But so that's our show for this week, folks. So be sure to come back and watch us next time on Auto Resto Mod. Have a great week, folks.
Thanks for watching. I'm going to miss Cam.
Me too.